Welcome to the next installment of our Ask a Scientist series brought to you by the National Weather Service in Las Vegas. Today, we will explore the formation of rainbows and double rainbows. Rainbows are considered both optical and meteorological phenomena. This is because we need both the physics of light, or optics, and rain showers to create a rainbow. Rainbows are caused by the refraction and reflection of sunlight within rain droplets. This means that there must be rain showers or another source of droplets in order for a rainbow to exist. While not necessary, it's helpful to have the sun at a low angle in the sky, such as near sunrise or sunset. You might be asking, what is refraction? Well, here's a hint. Think about the album cover from Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon. Refraction is the change in direction of a wave due to the change in medium through which it travels. In the case of a rainbow, the change in medium is sunlight traveling through air, then entering a rain droplet. If you recall from your school years, white sunlight consists of all colors in the visible light spectrum. Each color has a different wavelength, and each wavelength is bent at a slightly different angle. Thus, when a beam of light, indicated by the white arrow here, encounters a change in medium, in this case the triangular prism, the colors become separated. Note that not only does this occur when the light enters the prism, but also when it exits. This acts to amplify the effect. Now we'll look at the recipe for creating a normal rainbow, also known as a primary rainbow. First, the ingredients. We'll need sunlight, indicated by the white arrow here, a rain droplet, the blue circle, as well as two refractions and a single reflection. Sunlight enters the upper part of the rain droplet and is refracted once. Note that I'm only showing the red and blue wavelengths in this diagram for simplicity. The waves then reflect off the back of the droplet, and then finally exit through the lower part of the droplet, refracting one more time as it does. Note that the angle between the incoming sunlight and the red wave is larger than that of the blue. Because of this larger angle with the red wave, when viewed with the human eye from ground level, the color red appears higher in the sky than that of the blue or violet waves, which exit at lower angles. So in a primary rainbow, red appears on the outside with blue and violet on the inside. So what about double rainbows? Why are they less vibrant? And why are their colors reversed? Let's find out. Here's the recipe for creating a double or secondary rainbow. Once again, you need sunlight, raindrops, two refractions, but with the secondary rainbow, you need a second reflection. Let's see how this works. This time, the sunlight enters through the lower part of the rain droplet and is refracted. The waves then reflect not just once, but twice off the back of the droplet. Finally, the wave exits from the upper part of the droplet, refracting once more. Now let's compare this result to the diagram of the primary rainbow. With each reflection, light is lost due to scattering. Therefore, since the secondary rainbow requires two reflections, it always appears less vibrant than the primary rainbow. Also note that due to the addition of the second reflection, the colors become reversed. Notice that the angle between the red wave and the incoming sunlight is smaller with the secondary rainbow diagram. Since the angle of the red wave is smaller than that of the blue or violet waves in the secondary rainbow, red will always appear lower in the sky, so the colors are reversed when compared to the primary rainbow. Finally, note that all waves exiting in this manner exit at higher angles, thus the secondary rainbow appears higher in the sky. We'll close with one last fact. Since the human eye sees light from sets of millions of raindrops, and no two human eyes can be in the same place at the same time, no two people are seeing the exact same rainbow. If you guys have any questions, let us know in the comments or on Twitter or Facebook. Thanks for watching.